I'm going to be giving my speech on PEDs. And for those that don't know what PEDs are, they are performance enhancing drugs, aka steroids, aka the juice. I have three main points. One, they can mess up your life, not only physically, but psychologically. They have affected sports hugely. And if you don't really care about point one or two, I'm just going to tell you which one to take and which one to less likely fuck up your life. So, the effects. In simple terms, PEDs have the ability or potentially to drastically alter the human body, its functions, and considerably improve athletic performance. Originally, steroids were created for people who had delayed puberty and or other muscle wasting diseases, such as HIV infections. Now, for someone that would just want to take it just to work out, they should know that there are some physical and psychological baggage that comes with taking these steroids. For instance, some of the physical effects of steroids are severe acne, baldness, liver damage, and the closure of growing bones, which can result in the stunt of someone's growth. Now, that being said, aside from the physical aspects, there are plenty of psychological, like increased aggressiveness, sexual drive, and roid rage, which has been linked to criminal behavior. And then on top of all that, once you get started on steroids, the withdrawal is even harder to overcome, which in many cases have linked to depression, which is then linked to suicide. So take steroids. My next point is the effect on sports. Now, aside from its horrible side effects, steroids have been known to give extra strength, power, speed, and recover from injuries a lot quicker. And because of this, it's incredible upside. They have banned steroids at all levels, whether it's pros or collegiately. And just because it has been banned does not mean players haven't tried to get around the rules without getting caught. Such athletes as Ben Johnson, the Olympics, Lance Armstrong, who had to give up all seven Tour de France's back, and Mark McGuire. But the biggest cheater of them all, this man, Barry Bonds. If you don't know who Barry is, Barry was a baseball player at Arizona State University, where he had been to the College World Series, and he was already regarded as one of the top players to come out. He was selected sixth overall by the Pirates in the 1986 draft. Now Barry, as you see on the left, when he got into the league, he was 6'1", 185 pounds. When Barry finished his career in 2007, he was an astonishing 6'2", 230 pounds, and his hat size had increased by two sizes. It wasn't until 2003 where Barry's trainer, Greg Anderson, that man on the right, testified in a grand jury that he was supplying steroids to Barry in exchange for $25,000, $15,000 for the training and $10,000 for the steroids. Barry had finished his career with many accolades and is the all-time home run king and single-season home run leader with 73 home runs. But since he has been found guilty on four counts of perjury and one count of obstruction of justice relating to his testimony about his use of steroids, his chances of getting into the Hall of Fame are slim to none. And because of Barry's steroid use, he has paved the way not only for baseball but for all sports, what is acceptable and what is not acceptable in sports today. Now my last point, like I said, if you don't care about one or two, I'm going to tell you which steroid to take, just because, why not, get absolutely huge. And the steroid I found to take is Anadrol 50, which increases your red blood cell count, leading to increased pumps and increase in training endurance. The steroid's only downfall is it can turn your blood into maple syrup, and it can kill the liver, but out of all the other steroids, that was probably the best one out of all of them. And if you want to take HGH, there's a lot more terrible stuff than that one. My main points was one, it can mess up your life physically and psychologically. Obviously, it shapes sports what it is today, and if you don't care, Anadrol 50 is the way to go. Thank you for listening.